हाँ प्लीज कम इन, संदीप प्लीज टेक योर सीट.
थैंक यू सर.
संदीप हैज डन हिज
मैकेनिकल फ्रॉम डीटीयू सर. मैकेनिकल फ्रॉम डीटीयू सर.
मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम दिल्ली टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी. एंड ही हैज अपीयर्ड फॉर सेंट्रल आर्म्ड फोर्सेस. व्हाट आर यू डूइंग नाउ? आपने किया है 2016 में.
यस.
तब से लेकर आज तक क्या कर रहे हैं आप?
सर आई एम अपीयरिंग फॉर द इंटरव्यू एवरी सिंगल टाइम. I couldn't clear prelims in 2017. After that, appeared for interview in 16, appeared for interview in 2018, and this time also.
Interview आप पहले जा चुके हैं.
This is the second.
पहली बार तो आपको कोई नौकरी अभी तक ऑफर हुई है क्या?
No sir, I was not selected in any other.
Sandeep ji, and your subject is sociology. Mr. Sandeep, I would like to know the strength of Rajasthan. What are the strengths of Rajasthan and what is it progressing in?
So Rajasthan is a state, a very peaceful state. People very are very they have very hospitality, and they are very famous in hospitality, and tourism is, that's why, very growing in this in that state, and people love to visit from all the country and all over the world. And it is said that the culture of Rajasthan is very accommodative, where they don't they are able to very cosmopolitan in a way that doesn't discriminate in any towards any community. So that's why it's free from any communal riots and other incidents that are very prevalent in other states. So I think these are the strengths that Rajasthan
has. Into how many geographical areas you can divide Rajasthan into?
Rajasthan on the basis of geography, one part is where the desert area near the Rajasthan, Jaisalmer, Thar, and the area which is near Delhi, it's near Delhi is included in the national capital region. So they are more there is plain and lower ridges of Aravali, and in the south near the Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh border, they are badland topography, and ravines are also present. So
there are certain areas where you grow paddy also, like in Bharatpur side.
Yes.
And there are other areas where you don't, the desert area.
Yes.
So recently there are a lot of projects which are coming into Rajasthan for greening of the desert. What are those projects and what effect it has had in that area?
Sir, I am not aware of the specific project, but
have you heard about Indira Gandhi Canal?
Yes, sir.
Have you heard about Narmada Valley project?
Yes, sir.
What is the share of water and what are the projects and what are its effects in Rajasthan? Say first, the Indira Gandhi Canal.
Sir, I'm not aware of
this. You are not aware of Indira Gandhi Canal. Are you about this
Narmada
Valley project?
Yes, sir. I have heard about the protests regarding it. So I have read about it.
Yeah, and have you heard about a place called Sanchor? Where exactly is Sanchor?
No, sir. I have not.
Jalor district.
Okay. I have heard of it, but not. I don't know.
So
much.
You are not from Rajasthan?
Sir, I am born and brought up in Delhi.
In Delhi?
Yes.
Because your father was working here?
Yes, sir.
So you got no link with Rajasthan as such?
No sir, I have been there but very few times.
So original your district is comes from where?
My original district or my bit? I am born and brought up in Delhi in Southwest district.
But originally you are not from Bharatpur or that side?
No sir, my parents are from there but I was born and brought
parents
up in Delhi.
Parents are from which area?
Alwar.
Alwar, okay. So you don't have
that.
Okay, that is. Okay. Please.
Sandeep. What is the meaning of Sandeep?
Lighted lamp. Which likes to.
So you have written your this hobby that reading about international affairs.
Yes, sir.
What is your opinion about the way China is handling this coronavirus issue?
Initially, there was a report that a doctor tried to highlight this issue that there is some SARS-like virus that can spread, but the authorities tried to undermine it. So now that this coronavirus threat has increased, so initially there were lapses, but now China has taken some firm steps like. They have shut down few cities, transportation system, so that it doesn't spread to other areas. And so in a way, they have taken very resolute steps, which are, I think, enough to control this spread of coronavirus.
Shutting down a city, from yes. human right angle, do you think it is justified? There may be people who are not yes. affected by this virus.
But since it's very new virus, it is called novel coronavirus, so very little is known about it. So until there is some information regarding it, how does it spread and how what are the vaccines or what are the how it we can prevent
my
it.
My issue is that suppose yes. in this room we are in the city of China.
Yes.
All of us are there. Yes. Only that gentleman is having coronavirus.
Yes.
But all of us are locked down.
But
on that point of
so, but as I said, it's very new virus, so authorities may not be able to tackle it. So they will have to take some extreme measures. And if it's for temporary, then I think the human right angle can be we can ignore it for some time if we are able to save some life from coronavirus.
Suppose you are district magistrate of the city.
Yes.
What are the steps you would have taken? Three steps.
First, I would try to generate awareness about the virus, how does it spread, and try to make people aware how what they should do and they should not do so that it doesn't spread. And those people who have symptoms should immediately. I would ask them to request them to consult a doctor, and I would just head a bit. I would organize all the medical fraternity people so that they are appropriately funded, and all the equipments are and beds and all the infrastructure is in proper condition to handle any unforeseen. Scenario so that if there is a outbreak and serious threat of coronavirus, then they can handle it properly.
What about your own personal safety? Will you not be exposed?
So there, if
you are also exposed there, what you will do? You are your support. You may also get infected.
We can take precautions, but the health. Fraternity, the doctors are taking, we can wear masks and we can take precautions like constantly taking, not washing our hands and not getting near to the those who are infected, and using masks would be, I think, would be sufficient to protect ourselves.
I have two questions only from Delhi now, since you are from Delhi.
Yes.
And your father is in Delhi police.
Yes.
What was this ruckus about this Delhi police entering into the Jamia Millia University?
Sir, Delhi police is responsible for law and order situation. So if there is any incident where the law and order is going out of hand and they have to take certain action, then the officer, senior officer at that time, at that place, will take the decision. And if he thinks it's appropriate and it's sufficient, it's important, necessary for him to enter, then I think it's it was.
Yes, there was a demand from the student that FIR should be lodged against the police.
Sir, if there is any incident that where police use excess force against a student, then we can have a committee inquire into the incident, and if some cases of excesses are reported or find out, then appropriate action should be
taken. In this particular case, the vice chancellor of the university is saying that she never asked the police to enter.
Sir, there is no law, as far as I am concerned, that prevents police from entering any educational institution. It's just a courtesy that they offer to the educational institution and their chancellors, so vice chancellors. So, if the officer, at senior officer at that position, thinks that it was it is necessary for him to enter, then I think it was the right action he took and to control the law and order situation.
But in Jawaharlal Nehru, when there was a need for them to enter, there were a lot of violence which was going on in Jawaharlal Nehru. They were just not forthcoming.
Yes, sir. But the
Jawaharlal Nehru. As far as the need is concerned.
Yes, yes. But Jawaharlal Nehru incident, they. Jawaharlal Nehru has been in the students are there are in protest they are protesting against the authorities for a long time, so the police I think may not be able to
Sandeep, there are the two situations, the two universities not very far away.
Yes.
They must be around 15 kilometers apart. In Jamia they claim that BC is saying ki she never asked those people to come in. And there was a person who was studying in the library. They say ki he was injured. Here, the students were being beaten up. There, when the VC had not asked, the police had entered. And here, the police has entered, was asked to enter when there was need was there, they did not enter. How do you explain these two things?
If there was actually need and for police to
situations
enter.
Are in front of you.
Yes.
Both the situations are there. So you have seen these things. Right? Since your father is in the police, you must have watched it very closely. I would like to know the conduct of police in both those situations.
The conduct of police in JNU case is.
Let's talk about Jamia first and then JNU. Because in chronology of events, that thing happened in Jamia and then it happened in JNU.
Sir,
what happened in Jamia? Was it required to go there?
Sir, police responsibility is to maintain law and order. If they had to enter Jamia to control law and order situation, then they should have.
Good.
And if in JNU they did not, then I think they should. There are lapses and should be their police officers should be held accountable.
The last question on this issue. Recently there was a dispute between lawyers and Delhi police.
Yes, sir.
Delhi police, unprecedentedly, they came on road.
Yes,
because
sir.
The uniformed people are not supposed to
yes.
participate in trade union activities. Have you got Trade Union Act?
Yes, sir.
Armed forces are not supposed to.
Yes, sir.
Give me three reasons why this incident happened and who was at the fault?
Sir, main trigger point was regarding the fight over the parking space. So it escalated, and after that, there were rumors, and I think the fake news was responsible that there were rumors among lawyers that some lawyer was beaten up, and then they turned violent, and it was difficult for to control them. So main trigger point was the space over parking and the fake news that spread it among the lawyers regarding the manhandling of a lawyer. So this was the main reason.
Yes. Third.
After that, I think these two were the main.
Lawyers reason. Attacked the
yes
police station and.
Then situation, the main trigger point was parking space, but after that situation escalated and I think one thing led to another and it was that's why it out of control.
What is your view on the last part which I asked, that the police which they came on road?
Sir, I think police, it's true that under trade, according to Trade Unions Act, they cannot form a union. But they also are a human being and they also have certain rights and there also should their grievances should also be redressed. So they had certain demands and if and they should be able to to highlight those demands to the senior officers and authorities concerned, so that they are heard and certain action should be taken against to redress those grievances. So it was a limited time, limited protest where they agreed after some action were taken by the authorities. And so I think it was very limited time protest, and once they were assured that appropriate action against the lawyers who took law in their hand, then they took back their protest, and so I think it was limited and appropriate.
What is the status now? What is the status now?
So now, under Lieutenant Governor, they were trying to mediate and trying to solve things and solve the misconceptions between the two, and they're trying to start from.
Is there an inquiry commission?
Yes, sir.
Has there been appointed?
Yes, there is an inquiry commission, and
who's heading that?
Sir, I don't know, sir.
ओके
अच्छा संदीप ये बताओ
yes, sir.
कि मीनाज जो कम्युनिटी है एक बातचीत होती है कि अमंगस्ट द शुल ट्राइब इन नॉर्दर्न इंडिया दे डिस्प्रोपोर्शनेटली हैव ग्रैब्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द रिजर्व सीट्स मैं सही गलत नहीं बोल रहा एक इम्प्रेशन है तो एज अ मेंबर ऑफ द मीना कम्युनिटी तुम इस पर क्या विचार रखते हो? What's your view on this? Don't think that I am judging. I'm just trying to understand the mind of an educated, enlightened Meena.
So I think it's yes, it's there's a perception, and it's among the.
इसका कारण क्या है? तुम्हारे हिसाब से? Why they are they the leaders amongst others? ज़्यादा मेहनती होते हैं, ज़्यादा पढ़े लिखे होते हैं. क्या कारण है कि most of the jobs go to them amongst the should drive company? तुम्हें क्या लगता है इसका कारण?
Sir, I think they are educated, and their parents were educated, and now those people who could afford good education now are coming forward, and most of them they can aspire for top positions in the government, and so they can afford to prepare for some after their graduation and prepare for and for some for higher positions, higher the competitive exams. So I think their financial position and their parents' education and all these factors.
Are you aware of the population figures of the Scheduled Tribe? Because in the country,
yeah.
What is the population of Scheduled Tribe?
Sir, about 8%.
About 7.5%, 8%. And which is the most numerous tribe amongst these things, among all these tribes?
सबसे
बड़ा चंक किसका है?
गॉन्ड्स और मुंडास.
गॉन्ड का मुंडास का है. और उसमें मीनास कहाँ पर आते हैं इन दैट हायरार्की? अगर टॉप 10 पॉपुलेशन वाइज लोग हैं तो उसमें मीनास की क्या पॉपुलेशन है?
सर एग्जैक्ट नंबर आई डोंट नो.
और बाकी लोगों का रिप्रेजेंटेशन कितना है? और आपका मीनाज का रिप्रेजेंटेशन अगर मान लीजिए 7.5 सीटें हैं, उस पर सबसे ज़्यादा पॉपुलेशन का जो फिगर आती है ट्राइब्स में, कौन कौन किस उसमें जाते हैं, ये फिगर्स आप ज़रा जानकारी कर लीजिएगा. तो जानकारी होनी चाहिए, ये बात हो गई. दूसरा, आपको जानकारी के लिए बता दें कि 1979 जब तक कोठारी कमीशन लागू नहीं हुआ था, सबसे ज़्यादा इंटेक ट्राइबल्स के बीच में नॉर्थ ईस्ट का हुआ करता था, क्योंकि माध्यम अंग्रेजी का.
अच्छा.
और उस समय नॉर्थ ईस्ट के नागालैंड के जो ट्राइब्स थे उनका रिप्रेजेंटेशन ज़्यादा होता था. 1979 में कोठारी कमीशन लागू हुआ, जिसमें कि हिंदी माध्यम से लिखने का और कोई भी रीजनल लैंग्वेज लिखने का आपके पास रास्ता खुल गया. उसके बाद हिंदी माध्यम से जब रास्ता खुला है, तब इन लोगों का इनटेक आना शुरू हुआ, तब नॉर्थ ईस्ट वाले पिछड़ते चले गए. नॉर्थ ईस्ट वाले के बाद अब हिंदी माध्यम से आने के कारण जब लोग आ गए, फिर जो लोग नौकरी में आ गए उनके बच्चों ने शिक्षा बहुत तेज़ी से प्राप्त करी। जब नौकरी में आ जाते हैं तो आपका रास्ता प्रशस्त हो जाते हैं। तो 80 से लेकर आज तक आपका जो है करीब करीब 30-40-35 साल तो हो गए ना, तो इसका ये कारण है। इसको ध्यान में रख लीजिएगा, फिगर देख लीजिएगा और एजुकेशन का देख लीजिएगा क्या रहा, ठीक है?
ओके, सो यू आर ए मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर। Whenever there is a storm, the roofs of rooftops, no, they just blow up, है ना, छतें उड़ जाती है ना, which principle applies there? Any idea? Okay, what is Bernoulli's principle?
It means that when there's a the pressure increases, then the velocity, it's about pressure and velocity, a movement of fluid from a pipe or
aircraft ka jo principle hota udne ka Bernoulli pe hi puta depend karta hai. Full force is reacting upon a body once it is there.
Puta gaya, what is Bernoulli's principle? Kisi bhi tarike se samjha sakte hain, ye mat boliyega hum 3 idiots wale baithe hain. You can tell in any language.
Don't remember.
When speed increases, pressure decreases.
Yes.
That's why aapki roof
will lose.
Okay. What is entropy?
Degree of randomness.
Okay. What is second law of thermodynamics?
Degree of. We cannot create a engine which can complete a work.
Okay, tell me in terms of entropy, second law of thermodynamics.
I don't remember.
What is first law of thermodynamics?
The energy cannot be created or destroyed.
Okay. You know, you're doing drawing. This is top view. This is front view. Okay. So you need to make 3D view of this.
Kobe,
you have a pencil. Both are, I mean, सामने आमने सामने हैं. दोनों हैं आमने सामने हैं. जो box बने हैं वो एक दूसरे के सामने हैं. ठीक. Picture में थोड़े आगे पीछे. Same dimension.
अभी lunch करने की बात करो. नहीं तो फिर वो attachment हो गया.
इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर 2016 पास आउट
बट आई एम नॉट इन टच विद यस
एटलीस्ट ड्रॉ द फर्स्ट लाइन टॉप व्यू फ्रंट व्यू
said ignore human rights.
Yes.
You gave that statement. And then in the other matter you said police are human beings and they have the rights to, you know. Yes. Don't you think these statements are contradictory in themselves?
But in one case it was temporary and it was, I think, saving life was greater than, was more important than than the human rights of others who are surviving. So we should not put those other people's lives in threat. So I think it's for temporarily we can ignore. And in
but
case of
why can't we temporarily ignore it in the other cases?
In case of police, they had certain grievances which were which they were facing for some time, and it was I think. It was a result of long-term grievances that they took this extreme step of organizing and protesting for some limited time against the authorities so that they can be heard.
Fine. So what is your reason for wanting to join civil services?
My hobby is also to write letters to the editor, and whenever I read something, I have certain idea about it, and then I want that to be highlighted, that some people read about it, and I think it's better. My idea is better than what is actually the way things are done in the system. So I think I want to be part of the decision making where my ideas are heard and I can actually implement them rather than just writing letter to the editor where a few people read about it.
Have you written any letter recently to the editor regarding this topic?
Regarding Pakistan's blacklisting and FATF.
Blacklisting?
In FATF regarding terror financing.
फाइनेंशियल
एक्शन टास्क फोर्स
तो अभी जो CAA है उसका इंटरनेशनल जगत में क्या इसका इफेक्ट आया है
Some countries are trying to, like Pakistan is trying to encourage other countries to pass resolution so that this issue is highlighted, that India is painted in bad light. But I think those countries which are not well informed about India's act, India is trying to get them in confidence by talking to them. Initially, there were some remarks by some statesmen and some parliamentarians. But when India through diplomatic efforts, we try to engage them and try to present the actual picture. Then
You're talking about 370 or talking about CAA?
CAA, yes.
In the CAA?
Yes. Then they took.
United Nations has taken it up.
No.
Have they passed any resolution
about
it?
European Union tried to pass a resolution, but once India tried to use its diplomatic missions, and deferred it, and so that.
What is agitating the minds of these nations, United Nations or European Union, as far as our thing? It is our decision, and it is sovereign right of any country to decide upon its citizenship status.
Yes, sir.
What is agitating their mind? What is the grievance about it?
I think it's misinformation spread by the countries like Pakistan, which is the reason.
But besides the misinformation part, they must be having some information. What is agitating their mind?
Also, the protests in India and the way, the thing that Indian government is not handling the minority issue well. So they have some concerns. So they are trying to. That's why
what
they
is
are
the
trying.
Minority to issue in CAA.
The minority community thinks that it's discriminatory to exclude one particular community from getting a fast-paced citizenship.
Do you think that is the case in this particular thing in CAA?
So one particular community is excluded.
Which community has excluded?
Muslims.
Why it has been excluded?
So because the view of the government is that there is a religious persecution in the neighboring countries which are Islamic dominated and Muslim dominated, and there is religious persecution against these communities and no persecution of Muslims as they are Muslim majority. It's
but
assumption
Rohingyas by that. Rohingyas are Muslims or not?
So, who?
Rohingyas.
Rohingyas, yeah.
Which is related to the profess.
Yes, but CAA, the ambit of CAA covers only three countries, which are Afghanistan, Pakistan and Bangladesh. It doesn't include Myanmar.
And what about Sri Lanka?
Sri Lanka is also not included.
Not included?
In CAA.
Why?
So that part I think I cannot answer because government selected three particular countries.
Okay, thank you.
This is the drawing. This is the most easy one. Yeah.
रख लो आगे
काम करते चलो रख लेना बनाने में सब